particularly our parents who assemble here on these days in large numbers to cheer, applaud and participate in this very unique ceremony. I want to remind everybody that the date that my dear friend was talking about, the 15th of August 1947, Sri Aurobindo turned 75. And on that day, he addressed the nation for, you know, around that time, through All India Radio, through Chinnapulli, because you remember, Pondicherry was still part of French India, was not liberated on that day, and therefore Trichinopoly was the logical closest All India Radio station from where Sri Aurobindo's address could be relayed to the nation. In that, as you just heard, he set out five dreams of his, many of which were in progress, many of which awaited fruition. What I want to suggest is, 5 years from now, we will be celebrating the 75th Independence Day of India and the onset of Sri Aurobindo's 150th birth anniversary. It is very, very close. We have celebrated Tagore's, we have celebrated Gandhi's, we have celebrated many others. But we shall celebrate in 5 years' time, or beginning with five, at the, you know, at that point, the 150th birth anniversary of Sri Aurobindo and the 75th Independence Day of India. May I suggest that this huge and mammoth task and challenge, which my dear friend just outlined to us, the challenges that face the freedom of India, the unity of India, be comprehensively addressed in this 5-year time frame. It is difficult, but it is not impossible. And then I choose to veer from this path, from the nation, from Sri Aurobindo, from the macro, and come to something very micro. This celebration, today, our school, our institute, here and now. Today, in fact, since last evening, there are celebrations galore happening all over India and everywhere where Indians live across the world, celebrating this very special 70th Independence Day of India. This, by contrast, is a very humble, very modest, very tiny effort, almost a speck on the horizon, nothing much. But is it so? What we saw today was a comprehensive display, not only of the physical education that happens here, not only of what, you know, it is a comprehensive display of what they choose to be as people. Sri Aurobindo said, the mother said, that this school, this institution is for the holistic development of the human personality. The physical, the mental, the vital, the psychic and the spiritual. Today we saw the physical in abundance. We saw it also the vital in abundance. We saw that the participants were not just students who were compelled to celebrate their nation's independence. Every member of the staff of this institution has cooperated, has found time, as one of my dear friends said, took time off their busy schedule, took time off their work to make India's Independence Day and Sri Aurobindo's birth anniversary celebration an agenda of their personal lives. That is what makes it very, very important. We had a storytelling through the form of a skit. That story was from Sri Aurobindo, Komar Adarsho. It was written by him, one of his few writings in the original Bengali. That is another example of vital education. We had had this whole display of what happens, what can education be all about? What is it that Sri Aurobindo dreamt of in a nutshell? And I choose to go back to the skit that the children just performed this morning and the concluding lines of Sri Aurobindo's Komar Adarsho in its original. Bharate amon rishi chilen, amon sadhu chilen, amon Komar Adarsho chilo. Amon tapasyar bol chilo, যাহাদারা পৃথিবী ধারণ করা যায়। ভারতে আবার সেই রূপ ঋষি জন্মগ্রহণ করিয়েছেন, যাহাদের প্রভায় পূর্বতন ঋষিদিগের জ্যোতি হীনপ্রভ হইয়া যাইবে, যাহারা আবার ভারতকে পূর্ব গৌরব হইতে অধিকতর গৌরবে প্রতিষ্ঠিত করিবেন। So what he talks about is not only harking back to the glory of the past, but awaiting a future, working for a future that will be more glorious, more fulfilling, more noble, more total for India and for the world. In fact, as you well know, Sri Aurobindo suggested that India's independence was not for itself, not to make herself great, not to make herself assert her power brutally over the world, but to show the world the way to that brighter, nobler future. That is the agenda of Mother and Sri Aurobindo. That is the agenda of the Sri Aurobindo Ashram. That is the agenda of Sri Aurobindo International Center of Education. That is the agenda of Sri Aurobindo Institute of Culture. And that is the agenda of Arun Nursery and Future Foundation School. Today's celebration may be a tiny speck on the horizon. It may be nothing in its pomp and ceremony and its endeavor and its budgets compared to the millions of celebrations happening all over the country and all over the world. But it is a comprehensive effort to prepare the nation for the second wave of independence. It is a comprehensive effort to prepare our children and ourselves for the onset of tomorrow's India. An India that will show the path, first to itself and then to Asia and to the world. And that is the uniqueness, ladies and gentlemen, of this effort. That is the uniqueness amongst all the modesty, humility and tiny effort that has been put in. And that is why, with all of you, with all the stakeholders, I earnestly pray that Sri Aurobindo's 150th and the nation's 75th may be a deed for us to say comprehensively that at least we have taken a few strides in the direction of the second independence of India. Thank you. Vande Mataram. May I request you to take time off while on your way to leave, to see the charts that our children have put up, as always, because this was not the only thing that they put up. And also, since you've watched so much of effort from our teachers and staff members, please visit the meditation room. If possible, join us for the 10 o'clock meditation. Thereafter, we have songs by Nubuchanda Ghosh right in this auditorium from 10:40. In the evening at 6:30, we have the inauguration of the Freedom Exhibition at Gallery La Mer, to be inaugurated by Mr. Gautam Dey, Regional Director of the Rabindranath Tagore Center of the Indian Council for Cultural Relations. And finally, the message that has been distributed at Sri Aurobindo Ashram Pondicherry. You can see the card, and I'll just read from it. It's as usual, it's got the photograph of Sri Aurobindo. Sri Aurobindo, as he looked through the eyes of Henri Cartier-Bresson in 1950. And I'll just read the messages of the mother for this date. Il est venu dire à la terre de se préparer à un avenir lumineux. He has come to bid the earth to prepare for its luminous future. May we be worthy of his presence, because he is indeed present today. May we join him humbly in this effort to prepare India, to prepare ourselves, and to prepare the world for its glorious future. Thank you once again very much. Let's make this education of this school our efforts, an agenda for our life, an agenda where we participate consciously to make of ourselves what we need to be to show the way to the world. It's not empty promises, it's not empty words that will make India great. It's not through blaring microphones that India can proclaim. It is through our actions, it is through our deeds, it is through promoting that alternate lifestyle that India can be saved and the world can be saved too. Thank you very much once again.